Now, I meant to come up here and introduce our keynote speaker. However, you know, when we came to select the keynote speaker, actually, I didn't think the job's gonna be this easy, because our keynote speaker requires no introduction. Indeed, ever since I started following him on Twitter in 2011, Sultan Al-Qasimi has mesmerized the whole world, has brought intellectual analysis to the whole world, has helped indeed bridge the communication gap between the Arab world and the West. I am delighted that he's joining us as a blogger, but most importantly that he's here to give the inauguration speech of Al Arabiya English. And may I say, having achieved so much, having won so many awards, having spoken at so many international events, he remains incredibly as so humble as when we first met. So it is my great pleasure to introduce my dear friend, Sultan Al-Qasimi.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you, Faisal, for the very kind words. I think undeserved praise. But let me, I think, begin with a crafted speech so that I don't make any mistakes. First of all, it gives me great pleasure to be at this wonderful event, the launch or the relaunch of Al Arabiya and Arabiya English blog section. In fact, since its launch, Al Arabiya English has been instrumental in reflecting the hopes and the aspirations of, and the challenges, by the way, and the setbacks that this region has witnessed through a carefully curated selection of writers. And I've had the pleasure of writing for the website, I think, ever since the launch. And I was, in fact, again invited by Iman and Faisal to write an article for the relaunch today. In fact, I've been impressed by the variety and opinion on numerous matters, including religious, political, and social issues relating to the Arab world that are published on Al Arabiya. In fact, sometimes regional publications, especially in the Gulf, shy away from some matters that are really important to talk about internally, because if we don't talk about them here, they'll be spoken about elsewhere about us. So we have to write about this because, you know, we sort of reflect the society that we live in. And I'm not just talking about the national Gulf writers, but everybody who lives in the Gulf, I think, lives in the UAE, has a stake in the society. And I encourage you all to pick up a pen or a keyboard and start writing. With this launch, Al Arabiya is expanding its reach to include bloggers from the region and around the world, which will add another dimension to the debate. In fact, blogging in the Gulf goes back to the 1990s with pioneers such as Bahrain's Mahmoud Al-Yusuf, who is known as the blog father of the Gulf. And it's also an opportune time to mention a pioneer Saudi blogger, Hadir Al-Hudayf, who sadly died in 2008 at the age of 25. In fact, her blog, known as Heaven Steps, was one of the most important blogs I have ever followed. And I was very happy when I was visiting Qatar a few days ago, I met a professor who is archiving her blog now. And so it just goes to show you that, you know, blogging isn't just, you know, just random thoughts, but it's a pulse of society. So I commend you once again, Faisal, for doing this. Again, it's important for writers to instigate debate, reflect the pulse of society, but also to present new ideas. In one of the articles I had published a while ago, I had proposed granting of UAE citizenship to a certain a number of expatriates who live in the country. In fact, the article was so contentious that it caused an uproar in Emirati media and a hashtag of هذا الكاتب لا يمثلني, this writer does not represent me. And there was, I think, a dozen articles written basically in contradiction, in disagreement with that article. And I loved every single one of them, and I made sure to tweet every single one of them, because what we need is debate. And I had, honestly, I had thought that it was, I thought it was a lost cause, but I can tell you off the record, and just between us, that a few months after that article was published, I went and I met a senior official from here, from the UAE, and he said, and he had agreed with the article, said, Sultan, I agree with this, but things take time. But what's important is that the debate was initiated, even though some people got a number of articles against them, which was actually really great. So again, our region is desperate for dialogue and debate that is informed, updated, and diverse. And this is where Al Arabiya excels. Faisal, I have a request. please, please look out for new writers, new bloggers. Forget about, you know, people like me who have been writing for a long time. Find new voices. You know, 10 years on after I started writing, I am looking for new voices to follow myself. So please make Al Arabiya blog and Arabiya English the source for finding not only nationals in the Gulf, but any expatriate who lives in this region, I think, has the right to also speak about us and reflect the pulse of society. So thank you once again to Faisal J. Abbas, Editor-in-Chief of Arabiya English, and Iman Shinawi and their team. Thank you very much for inviting me.